Father God, as we thank you, dear Lord, I give you praise, I give you glory, I give you honor, Lord God. I thank you, Father God, for this opportunity, Lord God, to come and to stand in your presence, Lord. Father God, my prayer is that, Lord God, that I would decrease so that you would increase. Father God, I pray that, Lord God, that you would continuously be the fire in my hands, fire in my feet, and fire in my belly. Lord God, I thank you in advance for what you're going to do today. In the wonderful name of Jesus. Lord God, your word is already anointed. It's already powerful, Lord God. I just pray that you allow me to sustain the weight of your glory to bring it forth. In Jesus' name. I said amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Bibles. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord. You must understand that God is doing great things. How many of you know and believe that God's doing great things?
Yes, yes, Lord.
He keeps on doing
great things. Yes, Jesus.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. As we come today, as we study the Word of God, the Lord God says that in case you didn't realize that He is always present. Amen.
Amen.
I'm going to be asking you to turn with me to the book of New Testament, the book of John. I'm going down to St. John's house, John chapter 14.
Oh,
in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Yeah. Going down to John's house. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. John chapter 14. In the name of Jesus. If it's not a familiar passage to you, it should be. Hallelujah. And if it's not, it need to be. Get it to me in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. It's going to be very important for you to get the word today in the name of Jesus. You must understand. Thank you, Lord God. John chapter 14. I want you to put your eye on verse number 15 and 16. Amen. 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 The word of the Lord God says, if you love me, keep my commandments. And I will pray the Father, and he will give you another helper, that he may abide with you forever. Hallelujah. Just right there is enough to marinate right there. Amen. In the name of Jesus. I want you to understand that the word of God today, the word is help. Hallelujah. Help. That almost sounded like it's such an easy word, but it's called help. Hallelujah. If you're taking any notes, hallelujah. I've already proclaimed the message. Help me. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. The Holy Spirit, the Lord God says that Jesus said, when I go away, I will send you another. I will send you a helper in the name of Jesus. Some of you may think that you're in this world by yourself, but the Lord God said, I've sent you a comforter. I've sent you the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. Someone to help you along the way. I know at times that it may feel like that you're all by yourself, but the Lord God wants you to know that he said, if you keep my commandments. Come on, there are two requirements here. Come on, where are my students of the word? He said, if you love me, come on, you would keep my commandments. That right there I normally counts out about half of the people.
Amen.
Because they say that they love me, but then they don't want to do what God tells them to do.
Amen.
God says those who love me obey me. Come on now. So whenever God tells you to do something, you got to do it. If you don't obey him, that means you really don't love him. Come on now, because those that love God, that we're eager to do what the word of the Lord God has for us to do.
Amen.
Hallelujah. You're like, well, now everything that God asked you to do will be easy. I didn't say it was going to be easy. But the Lord God said that you must obey. He said, would you keep my commandments?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Do you understand that God gives us commandments every single day?
Amen.
That every day we get a new commandment. And for some of you, you need to understand that God says, one of the main ones, he said, I give you a new commandment to love. That you must love your brother and your sister. You must love. Love. Come on now. Tell your neighbor love.
Love.
Tell your neighbor outside love.
Love.
Come on. That's a new commandment that the Lord has given unto us, that we must love. If we love him and keep his commandments, the Lord God says, I will pray to the Father and he will give you another. He will give you Allos. He will give you the helper, the paraclete. Had that almost Sunday.
Yes,
which is the Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus. You must understand that the Holy Spirit, he is the paraclete. He is our helper. He is the one that helps us. And I said, I know I gave you the word help, but you might, in case you don't understand, help means to assist.
Amen.
Hallelujah. If anybody needs any assistance in the house, can I see a show of hands?
Amen.
Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I need the assist of the Holy Ghost every second of the day. Every second, not just every minute. I need the Holy Spirit every second of the day. He keeps me from going places that I shouldn't go. He stops me from saying what I shouldn't say. I need the assistance. I need for him to push something back, speed something up in order to help me. I need the assist of the Holy Spirit at all times. You must understand that we love God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. But the Holy Spirit is the comforter. He is the one that's here with us. The Bible tells us that Jesus sits at where? At the right hand of the Father,
that's right,
making intercession for
yes,
us.
Lord.
Day and night, I thank the Lord that he is in his position.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord God. I
yes,
thank the Lord,
Lord
that yeah. Jesus sits at the right hand of the Father, interceding on my behalf. Because do you realize every second the enemy is always saying,
amen.
Doing this, yes. Doing that.
Preach, Pastor,
doing
preach.
That. But if it wouldn't be for the Lord interceding on my behalf, and saying, you know what, that's not her.
Mm.
That's not what they're doing. That's not what they mean. That's not what they're saying. The Lord God sits at the right hand of the Father. And I would love to do a study on that. Bless God. People, you need to know the position of the role, the Trinity, the Godhead. He operates as one. God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. God is the Creator. Jesus is the Son of God. Come on now. And the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of God. They all are one, but they operate in different areas. Come on now. Operating together. You must understand that. That in itself is worth a shout and worth some power.
Amen.
To know that Jesus interceded on my behalf. To know that the Holy Spirit is here with us. I don't have to go looking everywhere out. I can just call upon him at any time. He's not. He's going to always answer the phone.
Amen. Amen.
That's what God is the name of.
Thank
that's
you,
one
Lord.
Person that I know. I'm not going to get a ring tone.
Yes, Lord.
Let it go. That's going to hang up on me.
Yes, Lord.
Because, you know, some of us, we get drunk calls. I don't know
amen,
about you, but
amen.
The Holy Spirit said, you'll never drop a call when you call him.
That's yes. Right.
No matter
Jesus.
What time you call him, no matter what, sometimes you can't even get the words out. You
ooh, Jesus.
Jesus.
Hey, the Messiah. You must understand that the Lord God is telling us that he has sent the Holy Spirit to help us. That he is the one to assist us.
Amen.
Whenever you have help, that means assist you in doing something.
Amen.
You know what God says? I put you here in this earth realm. And everybody has an assignment.
Amen. Amen.
Everybody's got something to do. You know, before you go to glory, God says you got something I'm requiring of you to do.
Amen.
Come on now, whether that be to sing, to praise, to give God glory, to heal the sick, raise
yes,
the dead,
Lord.
Cast out. Whatever Jesus. God's called for you to do, he does expect for you to do.
Amen.
Come
amen.
On now. But you know what? Sometimes we need the help of the Holy Ghost in order to assist us in the name of, I don't know about you, but I can't make it, as I said before, I can't make it without the help of the Holy Spirit. I need him every second of the day. Because you know what? He is my, the Holy Spirit, he is my help is coming, and my help is already here.
Amen,
now,
amen.
I need you to tell your neighbor, my help is coming.
My help is coming.
And my help is already here.
And my help is already
here. Let's start decreeing and declaring. Let's get that in the spirit. My help is coming.
My help is coming.
And my help is already here.
And my help is already here.
In the name of Jesus. You must understand.
Right.
Hallelujah. That Jesus, you know when we pray to the Holy Spirit, we say my help is coming. But I want you to get it in your spirit, man, that your help is right here.
Yes,
so that you know he's coming, but he's already here. Don't you like that? It's like a gift that you have that you never unwrap.
Yes, Lord.
I don't know about you, but you got
yes,
some treasures. Sometimes
yes.
You have something really special, but you never know that you got it. It's like an inheritance that you never
yes,
went to the bank to go claim.
Preach, Pastor,
Jesus,
preach.
The Lord got said, you got all of that. That's all you got to do. It's
preach,
just open
Pastor.
It up. Come on. You got to tap into.
Yeah,
almost telling you must understand that the Lord God's telling you that the Holy Spirit is right there. You just got to tap into him.
Yeah.
You just got to call on his name. In the name of Jesus. He is the one to help
power
us.
Right.
Oh, people of God, as I come
Jesus.
Before you today, the Lord God says that the Father, as I mentioned, Jesus intercedes on our behalf.
Yes,
turn with me to the book of Romans.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. We're talking about the Holy Spirit.
Mm. Mm.
Hallelujah. Romans chapter 8.
Jesus.
The name of Jesus. Oh, you know, I love to give you homework assignments.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. You're like, my God. Yeah, Romans chapter 8. Eat it up. That chapter should bless you. There's so much power in Romans chapter 8. Hallelujah.
Yes,
Romans chapter 8. Hallelujah. Look, I want you to put your eye on verse number 34. Just so that you know that it's coming strictly from the Word. Some of you may not know what that passage was, but look what the Lord God said. It says in Romans 8:34, he said, who is he who condemns? It is Christ who died. And furthermore, is also what? Risen. Who is even at, I told you, the right hand of God, making intercession for us. In case you're wondering where, well, I told you that comes straight from the Word. I'm not just making that up. The Lord God said, that's where he sits. He sits right there. Do you know the right hand of God is the right hand of power? Do you know that's why he delivers with the strong right hand? But as I want you to lay your eyes upon, go up a little further. Hallelujah. Verse number 26. Hallelujah. The word of the Lord God said, are we there?
Amen.
8:26 says, likewise, the Spirit, that's the Holy Spirit, also helps in our weaknesses.
Yes.
For we do not know what we should pray or as we ought to, but the Spirit himself makes what? Intercession for us with groanings in which cannot be uttered. You must understand that whenever that you are unable to pray for yourself, know that the Holy Spirit will pray for you. He is the one that would help us. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. I love it when the scripture says that with moanings and groanings. That means whenever you're in that prayer hour and you don't know what to say and you don't know how to get the words out, but he's in every he's in every groan. I don't know about you, but maybe you haven't lived long enough, but keep on living. There are going to be some times where you can pray when you don't have any words to say. Come on now. When you prayed about it just long enough, you've already called it out so many times. That Lord, and still nothing has happened. Come on now. You're still praying about that situation, and it still has not occurred. But when you get to the Lord, you just get,
Yes, Lord.
Because he knows exactly where you're going. He knows how you're praying. He knows exactly where you're going with that. Because you've said it so many times.
Yes,
the
Lord.
Only thing you can do is it's go, yeah,
more.
God.
Yes, Lord.
The Lord God said that the Holy Spirit will intercede for you right now. And intercede will be the one to help you. You must understand that the Lord God says, I know the words that you say. Yeah. I know the tears that you cry.
Yeah.
Yes, Lord God. He knows the pain that will not ever leave.
Yes, Lord.
When you're praying for that pain to leave and you have no words.
Yes, Lord.
He knows that the child is still has not gotten better.
Yes,
come on now. That, I'm talking, we're talking about people who need help.
Yes.
The Holy Spirit says that he's the one to help with that. Well, the sickness is still there. Come on now. Who do you call on? You should call on the Holy Spirit, the
yes,
one to help
Lord.
You.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. When that situation, that marriage is not getting any better. Come on now, you call upon the Holy Spirit. That's who you call upon when you keep praying and asking God, Lord God, why? You can call upon the Holy Spirit and he will definitely be there for you. You're like, I have no words to say. I don't want to say anything next. What you just do is just a groan in your spirit, man. And the Holy Spirit knows how to intercede for you on that behalf. He knows that you have a thorn in the flesh that
yes,
still
Lord.
Is troubling you.
Yes,
you
Lord.
Said, Lord God, I have a thorn. I don't know about you, but if you're in this house today and you need the Holy Spirit to help you, then I must understand that the Lord God said, I can take care of every thorn. In the name of Jesus, the thorn in the flesh that also buffeted me. How did I more as it buffeted you? How did I more Sunday? You need to call upon the help of the Holy Spirit. I tell your neighbor, my help is coming.
My help is coming.
And my help is already here.
My help is already
in the name of Jesus. You must understand. That thorn, the Lord God said that you will outgrow that thorn. You will outgrow that thorn. But the idea is that you got to continue to pray about it. You got to continue to call out unto the Lord about it. You know what? Let me bless somebody today. The Lord God said the only reason why I'm allowing you to continue in that thing is to keep you humble.
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus.
All right,
Lord.
It's
Lord.
Not in the notes right now.
All right, Lord.
Jesus.
Not
my Lord.
It's not in the notes.
Praise God.
The only reason why
Jesus.
The thorn has not gotten smoother.
Yes, Lord.
And you thought by now that you'd be much more mature than that. That the thorn would not hurt you. That the thorn would not trouble you. But the Lord God said, no matter what, even though you have a thorn in the flesh, yes. The Lord God said, yeah, as you cry out and moan and ask for the Holy Spirit to help you.
Yeah.
As I said it, and that is for somebody in the house right now. The Lord God said that the thorn is there to keep you humble.
Jesus.
It is to humble you. He said, I know you better than you know yourself.
Yes, Lord.
You said I won't get exalted, but he said, I know you.
Yes, Lord.
I knew you before you were in your mother's womb. I knew how you would respond to that. Too many hand claps cannot be good for you.
Yes,
too many well done.
Yes.
For some it's not good.
Yes.
Because the Lord God said, I know you.
Yes, Lord.
You'll forget that I died for that.
Yes, Lord.
Oh, that's a rough one right there, but yes. The Lord is speaking. Thank you, Lord God. You must understand that the Holy Spirit said that he's there to help us through those times. Tell your neighbor, my help is coming.
My help is coming.
My help is already here. You must understand that in Romans 8, the Holy Spirit in Romans 8:26, he said that in our weaknesses, when you are weak, thou make you strong. Am I right about it? Come on now. Whenever you need that help, the Holy Spirit is the one who will build you up where you've been torn down. He is the one that will come to your aid. He said he will make intercession for you with groanings and with that cannot be uttered. That groaning is the yearning. It's like almost like a travail, that almost Sunday that's in your spirit, man. And the Lord God said that is the help that we cry out for. I don't know about you, but you know what? It's time to call upon the help of the Lord in the name of Jesus. I know someone that will never disappoint you. I know someone that will not ever walk out on it. I know someone that's faithful, and his name is called the Holy Spirit. The Bible said that he is so faithful. He is faithful to you. That he will not ever leave you nor forsake you in the name of Jesus. As you're in your word, I want you to understand that, brothers and sisters, that the Lord God said that he is sending another, a helper, that you don't need to go looking across town for your help. The Lord God said, you don't need to go looking in other places. Look into the Lord. Look to the hills from which cometh your help, because your help comes from where? The Lord. Come on, sanctuary, talk to me in the name of Jesus. You must understand that the Lord God said that I'm a big God, that nothing is too difficult for me. Nothing is too hard for me. You must understand that in order for the Holy Spirit to be able to help you in your situation, you must realize that God is, come on now, that he is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, that he is great and mighty. Don't you know that God created your situation? Amen. Come on now, it's quiet in the house.
Yes, Lord.
Do you realize that the Lord created your situation?
Yes.
It is nothing too hard for God. God says, I know what you're going through. He said, I know because I created it.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord God. You must understand that he is the master of everything.
Yes.
When God creates something, don't you know that he's the master of it?
Yes.
Because if he created it, he knows exactly what makes it work, how to make it start, how to make it finish. The Lord God said he takes care of it. You must. The word of God tells me that the Lord God can speak to the deep and the water will behave.
Yes.
Do you realize you can speak to your mountain and it will behave in the name of Jesus? The Lord God said that's the creator. That's who we're dealing with. That's the type of help that we have. But before you can operate with the Holy Spirit helping, you must know that God is. Come on now.
Amen.
You must know that God is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. You must know that he is the creator of all things. You must understand, don't miss it. Don't miss it, people of God, that the Holy Spirit is your helper.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. As I turn with me to Psalms 27. Psalms 27 and 9. You're like, oh, wait a minute. Hallelujah. When you know that God is your King, when God is your creator, when God can take care of everything for you, you don't have a problem like David cries out. David cries out unto the Lord in Psalms 27, 9. Hallelujah. You know what? When you need the Holy Spirit, I don't know about you, but I can cry out unto him. When he said, don't hide your face from me.
Jesus.
Do not turn your servant away. Lord God, do not turn your servant away in anger. You have been my help. Do not leave me nor forsake me. I want you to understand that the Holy Spirit, he is the one that says, whenever you have a relationship with the Father, you can surely cry out unto him and say, Lord God, don't turn your face from me, oh Lord God. You know what I'm saying? Lord God, don't leave me when I'm going through my mess. Don't walk out on me when other things are going bad for me. Even though every situation may be going bad for me, but Lord God, that my help is coming and my help is already here. In the name of Jesus. I don't know where you are today, but I want you to know that the Holy Spirit is your helper. That he is the one that will comfort you. He is the paraclete. He is the one that will assist you in your decisions. Some of you are trying to make decisions and trying to do things all on your own, but I want you to understand if you don't have the Holy Spirit, it will not get done.
Yes.
Come on now, because you need the help of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Any decision made without him is called flesh.
Yes. Amen.
Any decision, I'm going to do a rewind. Any decision made without the Holy Spirit, it is called in the flesh.
Yes.
Amen. Because the Holy Spirit is the one to assist you. He knows what's up ahead. I'm here to tell you, not every decision that you're going to make that God is leading you to do is going to be favorable.
Come on,
come on now. You may not like it. It's almost like whenever your parent tells you something that you got to do and you don't want to do it. And many times you're like, well, Lord God, why? But I'm here to tell you it's best to be obedient.
Amen.
Because obedience is what?
Better than sacrifice.
You may not know what's up ahead, but the Lord God said, the Holy Spirit says, I know what's happening.
Amen.
I know, I see what you see. I know what you don't know. So you know what? The only thing you have to do is learn to turn upon the Holy Spirit for help.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. As the Holy Spirit will help you in your situation. As I move right along in the name of Jesus. You must understand the word of God is trying to tell us that you know what? That you can actually speak and remind God of his word. Come on now. The Lord God said he's given us promises. Remind him of his word. It tells us in the book of Isaiah, the word of God says, remind him of the word that he told you. If God said that he was going to bring you out without a cinch, you weren't going to get burned. Said, Lord God, you said, you made me a promise that me and my family was going to be taken care of. You made me a promise that every member of my household was going to be saved. Lord God, you promised me. In the name of Jesus, you promised me, Lord God. And that's all you have to do is remind God of his word. I'm going to give you that scripture. You don't have to turn to it. But people of God, you need to understand. What's amazing when I'm speaking about the Holy Spirit is quiet in the house.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
But to God be the glory. I'm going to pray that you receive it.
Yes, Lord.
I'm going to pray that you
yes,
receive
Lord.
It.
Yes, Lord. In the name
I don't
of
know
Jesus.
About you, but I've been crying out, help me, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
I need some
yes,
assistance.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
You know what? Whenever people need
yes,
government assistance, where do they go?
To, yes, Lord. Preach, Pastor.
They go to the office.
Yeah.
I'm at the sanctuary. I need some help.
Yes, Lord.
I need my help to come.
Yes, Lord.
And I need it for to be here right now.
In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord.
I don't know, I'm not playing around and waiting on it, but when I need help, I know where to, if people know where to go in the natural when they need help, what about the people of God?
God? Yes, Lord.
When they need help,
yes, Lord.
In the natural, the first thing. If something go wrong in the natural, and the world knows how to get help.
Amen. Yes.
The word. If I'm lacking in a bill, where do they go?
To the bill.
I'm just keeping it. Don't they go?
Amen. Preach, Pastor.
If I don't need some groceries.
That's true. Amen.
And you know, but why is it when it comes to the people of God, when it comes to the Lord, you need help in a spiritual manner. You need help with your children, help with your family. Where do you go? The Bible said we should go to the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And he would help us in the time
yes,
of need.
Lord.
You're looking here and there and everywhere. My God, the Lord God said, you just got to look within. He said, because I'm there with you. Those of you that are saved, you don't have to look out, look in.
Amen. Yes, Jesus. Lord. Yes, Lord.
My God. I mean, I tell you, thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Lord God, for breaking that. Because you must understand that if the world can know how to find help, why don't the people of God know where to
yes,
go to?
Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
My God, we go everywhere else but to God. Mm.
Jesus.
A lot of times we know when we get in trouble, you know what? Well, nah. After you done all that, well, I guess maybe we should pray.
Jesus.
You won't pray now? Maybe you've been praying before.
Yes, Lord.
My God. You can start
yes,
some prayers. Come on now.
Yes,
if
Lord.
You want to call upon help when you're, it's almost like somebody who know you know you can't swim and you're going to get in the deep water.
Jesus.
My God, before you got in the water.
Yes.
Before you got in your trouble, you should have put on your life jacket.
Amen, amen. Amen. Preach, Pastor. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I can go to the deep now. What's wrong?
Amen, amen.
I don't know how to swim, but I know how to wade.
Yes, Lord.
I know how to wade.
Yes, Lord.
Why? Because I got my help.
Yes.
If you can see that thing in the natural, as you see it in the spirit realm, see the Holy Spirit like your life jacket.
Jesus. Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. I know I can't handle what I'm going through.
Yes, Lord.
I look at that water deep.
Yes, Lord.
I don't have no swimming lessons at first.
Amen, amen.
And
preach,
the Lord
Pastor.
Says, get over to the other side.
Ooh, Jesus.
Oh, God. I don't know how I'm going to do it, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
But surely enough, now somebody who don't pray, they're going to get in there.
And drown.
And they're going to try, and they're going they want to pray. You better see that thing in the spirit realm.
Yes,
now
Lord.
You done got in your mess. Now you want to pray.
All right.
Now you done got too deep. The water over your head. You're doing like this.
Yes. Jesus.
Help me, Lord.
All of a sudden, you're underwater. And you know, like a good daddy that we have, you know,
Jesus
scoops right out. Yes. And he said, you know, and he picks us up. It's almost like he said, get over here.
Yes, Lord.
He said, my God.
Preach, Pastor.
He said,
preach.
I told you about that deep water.
Woo.
He said, the next time you go, you pray before you
yes,
get in
Lord.
There.
Yes, Lord.
Put the Holy Spirit on.
Yes, Lord.
But see, those of you who know how to pray before,
yes,
I'm trying to encourage you that
yes,
the Holy
Lord.
Spirit is your helper.
Yes,
you
Lord.
You put on prayer before you get in your
yes, Lord.
If you pray every day, you don't have a problem because he's right there with you.
Yes.
That's all you got to do is just, look, just push the button.
Yes, Lord.
The water come, the Lord God said, meet me on the other side. Got it.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yeah, that is good.
Because I'm going to be in the water. And they were looking around. Oh, God, I thought you didn't swim. I don't have to swim.
Yes,
but
Lord.
The Holy Spirit,
I can walk
can
through it.
You don't know how to do
Jesus.
All right.
Preach, Pastor.
Amen. When you got the Holy Spirit, yes. You may not have all the degrees and everything, but I got right, the Holy Lord. Spirit.
All right, yes, then.
Lord. I'm going to get I'm gonna be successful. You're like, well, yes, Lord. You don't have the MD and the PH and the comma and the RN.
Jesus.
I don't need all them.
Yes, Lord.
I just got J-E-S.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes.
When I got them letters, my credentials are good.
Amen, amen.
I'm going to tell you. Because I got some assistance. Yes. My Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Yes, Lord.
Help me get across.
Amen, amen.
I'm going to tell you, people of God, that you must understand that I told you my help is coming.
Amen.
And my help is already.
Yes, Lord.
Whenever we call upon the Holy Spirit, that know that he is an on-time God. That he is on time in the name of Jesus. You must understand that he's never late.
Yes,
he's
Lord.
He's always on time.
Yes, Lord.
In the name of, when you call him, he is there.
Yes,
that's
Lord.
That's what I like about God. Because surely enough, as I said it earlier, no matter what time I call him, he's always there.
Amen, amen.
No matter how much, you know, he don't say I'm tired of hearing you.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Woo.
I'm preaching right now.
Yes, Lord.
Now we just gonna make that thing nice and warm.
Jesus.
You know when you have a situation, yes, and you're always praying about it.
Yes.
And you tell somebody else about it. And you know that they people with you.
Oh,
people.
Yeah. Preach, pastor, bring it. They get tired here.
Oh, they're tired of hearing. But you know what thing about my daddy? As many times as I bring him, he hears it like he just heard it yesterday.
Yes. Jesus!
What's going on? What's
thank
happening?
You, Lord.
You're doing what? You're dealing with what? Yes. I'm there to help you. I'm there to help you. Don't you love that? Because you know what? But people, the Bible said people are just like grass.
They're widowing. Yes, Lord.
Oh, God, you better read your word. God. Just a widow.
Yes.
Widowing.
Jesus.
It's all gone.
They don't know you. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, when you're in your midst of your storm,
amen,
when
amen.
You know when you need God,
amen.
That's all you got to do is call upon the Holy Spirit.
Yes, Lord.
Say, help me.
Lord. Yes, Lord.
I call upon yes, the one Lord. That will never leave me.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I'm telling you, whenever I'm going through my toughest time, I'm preaching to somebody up in here. I learn that I don't have to look out. I start looking in.
In.
And you make me wonder, why isn't she talking? Because I'm going in.
Yes, Lord.
Hey, the most thunder. Why am I not fellowshipping? Because I'm going in.
Yes,
why?
Lord.
Because I got something that I need to take care of. And only the God that's in me,
amen.
The Holy Spirit that can help me, get me up out of what I need to get out
amen.
Of.
Amen, amen.
In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You must understand that he is our helper. The Holy Spirit is the one that's going to help us across.
Yes.
He's going to help us in our time. He said in Isaiah 59:19, you can make a note of it. The Bible says when the enemy comes in, like a flood.
Yeah.
I don't know about you, but the enemy don't wait for a special occasion.
Preach, pastor.
If you know anything about flood waters, you should
Jesus.
Know by living in this area.
Amen.
They don't wait. They don't give you no warning. Before you know it, it's coming in the door. Next thing you know, it's up to the steps.
Amen.
All
amen.
Of a sudden, it's coming to bed.
Preach,
it's
pastor.
To the roof,
preach, pastor.
Like a flood.
Blood.
That's right.
But you must understand that the Spirit of the Lord said that I will lift up a standard.
Yes, Lord.
The Lord God said that I will.
Yes.
That's a nugget right there. Some of you need to make a note of Isaiah 59:19.
Yes,
he said, when the enemy comes in, like a flood. When the enemy
comes
in. He doesn't wait for anymore. He just comes in.
Mm-hmm.
He don't wait for you to invite it. Well, how many? How many of you invited flood waters in?
Nobody. Preach, pastor.
You close the door, lock the door.
That's
amen.
Right.
And still coming in.
Jesus.
It's just like the devil.
Yes,
no matter what,
yes.
You close every door.
Yes.
You said, I got everything complete, the blood of Jesus, before you know, look at me.
He's
look
back again. Uh-huh.
Coming in.
That's mm-hmm. Right.
Coming preach in from pastor. The sneaking in.
Yes.
The name of sneaking
yes.
In. You're like, Lord, I plead the blood of sneaking. Jesus, and I'm going to send it. And it's still sneaking in.
Yes.
If you can see the enemy like flood waters,
yes.
That's how I'd like to come in. Because you're not prepared for it.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Come on up in here.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
I keep sandbags every day.
Jesus. Yes, Lord. Preach, pastor.
My God.
Yes, Lord.
See, some of us think, you know, when you keep sand, you don't keep sandbags at your at the all the time. Listen, you know what? You'll never go anywhere.
Amen.
Am I
amen.
Right,
yes,
you'll
ma'am.
Never move, and that's what the enemy would like for us to do. God bless,
God bless
you. The enemy would like for us to stay boggled down. Stay here, no. I'm not going over there.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
I'm not going to. God didn't give me the spirit of fear,
but power, love, and a sound mind. Yes, Lord.
I'm going to go, I'm going to unlock my door.
Yes, Lord.
Open the heights of my windows.
Yes, Lord.
Glory to God. Hallelujah, because I know that the Lord said that he's going to lift up a standard.
That's right.
Surely, enough, because flood waters come in without a warning. Mm-hmm. And when they start coming in, when the Lord got to look at the word. It says, when the enemy comes in like the spirit of the Lord, yes, will lift up a standard against them.
Yes.
Will lift up a standard against them. You know what? That's almost like the water coming. You know, the spirit said, oh, you ain't going over here.
That's right.